Hello students, before we start our chapter, I would like to request you all to watch our introductory two videos given by me so that you will be clear about the three-step strategy to do dhamaka in physics exams. We have given the videos in the description box, or you can just click on our videos displayed at the end of this video for either introductory two videos or the next videos. Okay then, let's enjoy physics by Mr. Patel, who has a long, profound experience of 29 years of teaching physics in Sainik School, Balachand.
Energy stored in an inductor, that is, energy stored is equal to the work done, W is equal to half Li square. When an inductor is connected to a source of EMF, the current starts growing through it. An induced EMF is produced, called the back EMF. We have already studied. In the back EMF, that is produced in the inductor, which always opposes the growth of the current through it, according to Faraday's first law, correct? So whenever there is a change in the magnetic flux linked with the circuit, an induced EMF generated, which opposes the very cause producing it. So the work needs to be done against the back EMF in establishing the current. So in order to maintain the current, the work has to be done. This work done is stored in the form of, in the inductor, in the form of the magnetic potential energy. That is U is equal to, or W is equal to half Li square. Work done, that is stored as a potential energy U. Let I be the current through the inductor at any time t, the rate of work done, that is power, dw by dt is equal to EMF into current, voltage into current. If we ignore the resistance losses and considering only the inductive effect, that is, the inductor is after all made of a copper coil and it has a resistance, but negligible resistance, so inductive effect is not negligible, so we will consider only inductive effect and neglecting the resistance of a copper coil of which the inductor is made of. So dw by dt is equal to ei, but e is equal to minus L di by dt according to Faraday's law, correct? So emf e is equal to minus L di by dt. So put this value of e into this equation, so dw by dt is equal to L di by dt into I, that is Li di by dt. Therefore, dw is equal to Li di, correct? Dt will cancel. Now, total work done can be obtained by integrating this equation from I is equal to 0 to I is equal to I, correct? The total work done in building up the current from I is equal to 0 to I is equal to I is the W is equal to integration of this equation dW, that is integration of Li di from 0 to I, that is equal to L, the integration of I is I square by 2, that from 0 to I. So put this value, that is half Li square. This work done is stored as the magnetic potential energy. So potential energy stored in an inductor is half Li square, just like the mechanical energy in the body moving at the velocity v, half mv square. M plays the role in the mechanical energy, the same role is being played by the inductor in electricity. Now, grouping of inductances. There are two inductances here, grouping of two inductors L1N having the self inductance L1N, L2 respectively. The current flowing is the same sense. This connection is said to be a series connection. So inductances are connected in series. This. So flux will be added here. The flux due to this itself, that is self inductance, plus flux due to the magnetic field link with the L2 also. Correct? Current due to in the L2. So there will be the total flux will be added up as current is in the same sense. Let the series connection be such that the current flows in the same sense in the two coils as shown in the figure. The flux linked with one coil will be the sum of the two fluxes which exist independently also. So flux in this is due to this self induction plus flux due to link with due to current in the L2 also. Similarly, flux in this also will be the self induction of the L2 plus flux due to the inductor current flowing in the inductor L1 also. So they will be added. So we know the general equation N1 phi 1 is equal to M12 I2, correct? This is general equation. So N1 phi 1 here, in the, we will modify this equation due to the inductive effect of both. That is M11, that is just like the L1 of this, plus the flux leakage in this with this coil due to the current in this coil, that is M12 I2. Correct. So mutual inductance of one due to the current in the two coil, and current in the two coil is say I2. Correct. We have written I, that is finally we have considered that current is the same. If different current is flowing here I1, here I2, then you can write this N1 phi1 is M11 I1 plus M12 I2. This is a general case, where M11 is the inductance of first coil, this coil represents the inductance due to the same coil. Using the Faraday's laws, induced EMF is equal to minus M11 di1 by dt minus M12 due to the current in this, that is di2 by dt. Now put this value, M11 is L1, you can write here directly also L1 and write this equation, correct. So EMF induced in this E1 is equal to minus L1 di1 by dt minus M12 di2 by dt. Similarly for E2, minus L2 di2, replace the L1 by L2, M12 by M21, and I1 by I2. So, correct, you will get the E2 is equal to minus L2 I di2 upon dt minus M21 di1 by dt. So, if I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I, and also mutual induction is same, that is M21 is equal to M12, we have already studied, that is equal to say M, then equation will become E1 is equal to L1 di by dt minus M di by dt. Similarly for E2 is equal to L2 di by dt minus M di by dt. Now total effect, this EMF, E equivalent is, E equivalent is equal to E1 plus E2. E equivalent is equal to E1 plus E2. And let the inductors, equivalent inductors is also L equivalent. So E equivalent is equal to minus L equivalent di by dt as this, correct. So comparing these two, L equivalent into di by dt is equal to E1 plus E2. So E1 is this and E2 is this. So L equivalent into di by dt is equal to E1 plus E2, that is take the minus sign and take the plus outside, so it will be a, and di by dt also common, so L1 plus M2, minus sign is taken outside, so L1 plus M, M plus L2 plus M, so L1 plus L2 plus 2L into di by dt, di by dt is common, so L equivalent is equal to L1 plus L2 plus 2M. Next. Example 6.10 on page number 224. A. Obtain the expression for the magnetic energy stored in a solenoid in terms of a magnetic field B. Area A and the length L of a solenoid. The data of the solenoid is given, correct? So we have to calculate the magnetic energy stores in terms of magnetic field B, area A of the solenoid and length L of the solenoid. And compare this with the electrical energy stored in a capacitor. Correct? So we know that, we already studied just now, that magnetic energy stored in an inductor is half Li square. Now for the solenoid, magnetic field is given by mu 0 ni. We want I, correct? We have to I. So I we will get from the magnetic field of the solenoid at the center. It is given by mu 0 ni. So I is equal to B upon mu 0 n. Is equal to B upon. So I square is equal to square of this, that is B square upon mu square, mu 0 square n square. See this equation 1, this equation 2. Also L is equal to mu 0 n square A L. So substituting the values of I square and L from the equation 2 and 3 into 1. We want this energy. So U B is equal to half into L, that is mu 0 n square A L into B square upon mu 0 square n square, that is I square. I square is equal to B square upon mu 0 square n square. So U B is equal to this n square cut, mu 0 upon mu 0 square, that is mu 0. So B square A L upon 2 mu 0. This is the energy stored in, correct? The magnetic energy per unit volume is the divided by volume. The volume of the solenoid is length in equal to length into cross section area A, that is A L. So UB is equal to UB, that is small UB is equal to capital UB upon V. This is the magnetic energy per unit volume, that is energy density also called, that is equal to total energy UB upon volume AL. So AL will be cut. So half B square upon mu 0, that is half B square upon mu 0. Compare this. Energy stored in the unit volume of a parallel plate capacitor is half epsilon 0 E square, correct? So energy directly proportional to square of the field. Here also energy stored is directly proportional to square of the magnetic field, as we have compared earlier in the case of the mechanical energy, half mv square and half li square. Half, that is whatever role is being played by the mass, that is inertia, correct, is played by the inductor in the case of magnetic field. The example 6.1 of the exercise, first example on page number 229. Predict the direction of induced current in the situation described by the following figures. The first figure, see one coil and the magnet is moved toward the coil. The S pole is moved toward the coil, so it will induce the S pole according to Lenz's law, correct? So it will tend to opposite. So current will be, that will induce, is have a south polarity, that is current will be the clockwise like this, correct? That is PQRP. Current will flow like this clockwise, correct? PQ or QRPQ, this direction. Now second, here there are two coils. So when S pole is moved toward the left side coil, correct, so this will move, so it will induce a south pole nearby, correct? So current will be clockwise, that is PRQ. Here N pole will move away, so it will induce a south pole here. That is current will be clockwise from here, and here north pole this side. So correct. So current will be Y, Z, X in this direction. So here PRQ in this direction, PRQ here, Y, Z, X direction. Next is the D. That is here, when key is pressed, the current increases. Increasing current will increase the flux. So increasing flux should be opposite by Lenz's law, correct? So it will oppose the flux. So here the current is clockwise, here will be like this, correct? YX, ZYX. So here current will be in this direction. can draw this also here, y z x here, p r q. Now here the d, here the rheostat is adjusted, arrow shows that this point moves upward. So here resistance introduced will be less, current is flowing, this is positive, so current is going like this. So from this it comes out from this to the negative, this is a circuit completed. So if you put point here, resistance will increase, so resistance will increase, the current will decrease according to Ohm's law. If you move the arrow, this contact to the rheostat at this point of the rheostat, then the resistance will be less of this length of the wire will be introduced in the circuit. So less is the length, less is the resistance, so and more is the current. So increasing current will increase the flux. By Lenz's law, increasing flux will be opposed by this, correct? So the current will be opposed and flow in the opposite direction. Now here the circuit is broken, the key is open, left open, so current will decrease. So decreasing flux will be opposed by, so current here will flow in the x or y direction. This is, you can try it, x or y. Here current is decreasing at a steady rate. We know that the magnetic field produced is a circular rings given by the Fleming's right hand rule. This is the current, thumb shows the current, the curl finger will give the magnetic field lines. So magnetic field and the flux will be along the plane. So no flux is along the perpendicular to the plane of the coil. It is in the coil, in the plane of the coil. So total is flux is zero. Magnetic field lines are in the plane. So no field lines are perpendicular to the plane of the coil. So any increase or decrease in the current will not change the magnetic flux at all. AC generator. A generator or a dynamo is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. The AC generator is one which produces current that changes its direction periodically. The principle of generator. It works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. Correct? When a closed coil called the armature coil is rotated in the uniform magnetic field with its axis perpendicular to the magnetic field, field B, the magnetic flux linked with the coil changes due to the orientation changes, and an induced EMF and hence current is produced in the coil. Now construction. You can see the construction, it consists of the two magnets, these are NS is the magnets, is a field magnets called, is a U shape in the case of a small dynamo, and a big, it is an electromagnet. This is armature coil or armature, or simply armature or coil, correct, P, Q, R, S. The ends of the coils are connected with the brushes, carbon brushes, graphite brushes B1 and B2. The end S is connected with the B1, and this is not touching with the B1, but correct, they are coaxial and is connected with the B2. The S1 and S2, they are the two slip rings with the ends S and the P are connected. S is connected with the slip ring S1 made of brass, and P end is connected with the S2, correct? Rings are connected with the carbon brushes, graphite brushes, and they are connected with the line wires. So it consists of these parts, NS field magnets, PQRS is armature coil, S1, S2 are the slip rings made of brass, B1, B2 are the graphite brushes, keep contact, close contact with the S1 and S2. Source of energy, that is source of energy may be a, that is a hydroelectric power plant. The coil is rotated by adding the water force energy. Water is allowed to fall from the great height where it is stored in a dam, is allowed to fall on the turbine. Turbine is coupled with the coil. So turbine rotates, the coil also rotates. When it rotates, there is a change in the magnetic flux linked with the coil. It is correct. This is axis, which is perpendicular to the magnetic, uniform magnetic field B produced by magnets. It consists of a coil mounted on a rotor shaft. The axis of the coil, axis of the rotation of the coil is perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field B. The coil called the armature is mechanically rotated in the uniform magnetic field B by some external means. That is, it can be rotated by using the water force energy, water, or the potential energy of water in the case of the at hydropower plant, or at thermal power plant it can be rotated by using the steam energy, or in the nuclear power plant also steam energy, but in nuclear power plant the steam is produced by using the nuclear fuel, whereas in the thermal power, at the thermal power station, the steam is produced by burning a coal or this oil. Correct. At hydropower plant, it is the cheapest plant. Water energy of a waterfall is used to run the turbine, which is connected, coupled with the coil. So coil rotates, the turbine rotates. So coil causes the change in the, then when coil rotates, there is a change in the orientation. There is angle theta with the magnetic field, and hence flux changes. The ends of the coils are connected. So an induced EMF and hence currents are produced or generated in the coil. The ends of the coils are connected to the external circuit by means of slip ring and brushes, carbon brushes. Now, correct, working. When the coil is rotated with a constant speed, the theory and working, W omega, the angle theta between the magnetic field vector B and the area vector A, which is perpendicular to the plane of the armature coil, of the coil at any instant t, is theta is equal to omega t. Assuming theta is equal to 0, at t is equal to 0, at time t is equal to 0, theta is 0. Thus, flux linked with the coil changes due to the change in the orientation. The flux phi at any time t is given by the, we know that flux is given by B dot A, magnetic field into area vector perpendicular to the plane of the coil. That is B A cos theta is a dot product of two vectors. B is a magnetic field vector and A is a area vector. So phi B is equal to B A cos theta, that is equal to B A cos theta is equal to omega t. Omega is the angular velocity and theta is the angular displacement. So omega, angular velocity is the theta by t. So theta is equal to omega t. From the Faraday's law, the induced EMF is the rate of change of flux, that is E is equal to d phi by dt of this. And if coil has n turns, then it will be n d phi by dt, or flux will be n times. So take the derivatives of this, n d phi b by dt, that is equal to minus n d by dt of b a cos omega t. That is equal to minus n b a, these are constant, only theta is variable, that is omega t is variable. So the sine cos omega t is minus sine omega t. So minus minus plus, that is induced EMF is n b a omega sine omega t. Correct. So cos omega t, the take the function, this is equal to say y, then take the whole function and then do the derivatives of omega t. That is omega t is omega. Therefore, induced EMF E is equal to E0 sin omega t. Say equation 1. E0 is equal to nBA omega. That is maximum. When sin omega t is 1, that is omega t is 90. Theta is 90. Again, or 270 also, that is minus, but it will be maximum. Again, omega is equal to 2 pi upon t, that is equal to 2 pi into nu. Nu is the frequency, 1 upon t is the frequency of rotation. So, instanted value of EMF from equation 1 will be E is equal to U 0 sin 2 pi omega is equal to 2 pi upon T, that is 2 pi nu into T. Since the value of the sine function changes, we know that sine theta changes from plus 1, between plus 1 and minus 1, the sine of or polarity of the EMF and hence current changes with the time. So, E is maximum when theta is 90 or theta is 270, that is in the negative side minus. As change of flux is maximum at these two points, the direction of the current changes periodically and hence the current is called the alternating current, because direction of the current changes alternately after the half time period. So, it is called the AC current or AC generator. The instantaneous value of the current and the EMF varies between plus E0 and minus E0 periodically. That is E equal to E0 sin theta. If theta is 0, the EMF is 0. If theta is 90, EMF is maximum, that is E0. If theta is 180, it is again 0. If theta is 270 degree, then it is minus E0. Sin 273 is minus 1. So, if theta is 360, again it is 0, that is sin 2 pi. Sin 2 pi is 0. Now, these are the diagrams at different angles. This is the first position, correct? The plane of the coil is perpendicular to the B. That is, plane of the coil is perpendicular. This is, suppose this rod is magnetic field direction and this is the coil, armature coil. So, it is perpendicular to this. That is, what is the angle between the area vector is normal to the plane of the coil. So, that is 0. So, angle is 0, so EMF is 0 and time is 0. This is the time axis, this is the EMF axis. So, when it is rotated 90 degree, when it is rotated 90 degree, that is angle between the B field is in this direction and area vector is 90 degree. What is the angle between B and A? Correct? So, it is parallel to the magnetic field, but area vector makes 90 degree. So, angle is 90 degree at the time t is equal to 1/4 cycle, that is t by 4. Correct? It is maximum. EMF is maximum, sin 90 is 1. Again, when it is rotated further, that is 180 degree, this side has come, this was at the bottom, it has come up, and this has top, it has come down. Correct? So, when 180, the again it is 0. Remember? That is, the angle is 180, the rotation is 180 and magnetic is perpendicular with the plane. So, again when it is, that is 180 is 0, sin 180 is 0, is at time t by 2, that is half root cycle, this is half rotation. Correct? Again, when it is rotated further in the same direction, same sense, then after 270 degree, correct, that is 270, that is 3 by 4 time period is 3 by 4 t, that is, it is again maximum, but in the opposite direction, that is minus c, sin 270 is minus 1. Again, when it is rotated, the same position it has occupied, that which was the first position, that is perpendicular again, but same with SR, correct? The ends are the same. So, complete rotation, that is 360 rotation, 2 pi rotation, we can say that is at the time is equal to t, again it is 0, so, correct?